Gloria. You're always on the run now, running after somebody. You know you got a dough down. I think you got a nail down. Before you got the dough in, I think you're headed for a breakdown. So be careful not to show it. You really don't remember. Was it something that he said? All the voices in your head. Call it Gloria. Gloria. Rebound. Will you make the money? Take a lover in the afternoon. Hey, don't get it on the back soon.
And other fixings out of steel, plus gutter pipes to die for, and more ladders than you could shake a stick at. Planning on a bit of soldering? We've got soldering wire coming out of our storage boxes on sale
blue.
For a limited time from just £8.
Cheers.
Yellow.
That's just about songs as well.
Another great song on Forever FM. Timeless hits now and forever. Richard Marx and Hazard.
Oh,
I don't need this.
Timeless hits on Forever FM.
I do not need this.
Beautiful song.
Oh, this is horrific. What are they playing this for?
It's about you. You're a hazard.
I'm not backwards.
What?
He's backwards, the lad, in this song. He's not playing with a full deck. Listen. Mother called me Hazard when I was just 7. Even then, the folks in town said with prejudiced eyes, that boy's not right.
Oh, I thought it just meant he was naughty.
No, he's not right. This is his girl, love. First time someone looked beyond the rumors and the lies, saw the man inside. Bloody bleak, this. We used to walk down by the river. She loved to watch the sun go down. And he kills her. We serial killer. What do you reckon? Well, oh, forget a grip. You're not crying at Hazard, are you?
It's just so sad.
You're having a laugh.
She's dead!
No one understood what I felt for Mary. No one cared until one night she went
walking all alone. Then never came home. That's because he killed her on a wheelie bin.
Man with a badge came knocking at
the police, are you now?
Gets the blame.
Yeah, because he's killed her.
But he didn't do it.
He did do it.
Swear I left her by the river.
This is his last image of her by the river.
This is alibi to police. Get a grip.
Drive it, Joyce Chung on checkout?
Husband's a wrestler.
Well, she says he is. Have you seen him?
Yeah.
It's massive.
Huge. Sumo.
Is he a sumo wrestler?
Yeah, of course. You've seen the size of him.
I've never seen him in his costume. I didn't know.
I've not seen him in his costume, but I know he's a sumo wrestler. A bit like a brick shithouse.
Anyway, I've got a bit of a problem. I really need to put the second week of September off.
Yeah.
Joyce Chung's already got it off.
Yeah.
It's really, really vital that I have that week off.
Why?
Well, I've told her I'm having her ingrown toenail taken out, but I'm actually going to Corfu.
You've told who this?
Joyce Chung. She won't swap with me. Is there anything you can do?
I have nothing to do with holidays and admin and all that. What are you asking me for?
Well, you're pally-pally with HR.
But the mean I'm pally-pally. I don't deal with holidays and all that. You speak to Kath Hilton, she'll sort you out. You know
well,
her, don't you?
Kath Hilton.
And what'd she say?
Well, she quizzed me a bit because I used that excuse last year.
Well, there you go. This is your lies tripping you up. I've told you about this before.
I know. Well, at first I said thrush and she just gave me some yoghurt.
Why would you do that?
Why? She caught me on the hop.
What, you're hopping around with thrush for?
Oh, please.
Please what?
I booked it. I can't get out of it now.
Who's ever had a week off with thrush?
Well, what would you say?
I won't say thrush.
Well, what would you
say? I wouldn't lie for a kickoff. All
well,
right.
I had to lie because well, I'd already booked the holiday before checking the rotor.
What does Joyce want it off for?
She's going back to Japan. Her mum's just died.
Oh, well, something and nothing, isn't it?
Exactly. Ali's £175 deposit.
She's lost her mum.
Well, she's still going to be dead the third week of September, isn't she?
You can't say that for the love of Jesus.
She will be, won't she?
Well, you've no comparison there. You've got a family funeral.
Well, if I don't have this holiday this year, I can't go again.
Well, why not? Why can't you go sunny weather in November, December?
Because it's the only week that I can get to go with Armandy. Don't you think I deserve it?
I think I deserve a bloody holiday after driving you in every day.
If you get me the week off, you can come with me.
I don't want to go to Corfu.
Why?
You don't have toilets, just have holes in flooring.
No, it's not 1956, John.
That's what they have.
Have you been to Greece?
I know what goes on in Corfu.
Doesn't happen anymore.
They don't have a proper drainage system.
I know, but it doesn't matter if it blocks
up. Who wants to squat over a hole?
You don't squat over a hole.
Of course you do.
You just have to put your tissue in the bin next
to
you, which I don't do.
No.
I break the rules, put it down the toilet.
What?
I don't care if it blocks.
Kind of an all-inclusive holiday. You've got to put your bloody shit rags in a bin.
I love the Greek people. Yamas.
Same to you.
Our world-class creative stylists know all the latest haircuts, including the weave, the buzz cut, the angel, and even the waterfall braid. Our salon
the what? Waterfall braid?
Braid?
What's a waterfall braid?
So you can look like that.
In the face for the first time in years. Cut above.
Where'd you get your hair done?
Friend does it.
Friend does mine.
Who does yours?
My mate Iqbal does it for free.
What?
Nothing. Is he a hairdresser or is he just... No, he's a hairdresser. He cuts hair. He's mobile, but I don't think I'll go to him anymore because I went round the other week and he did it in the back kitchen and his daughter comes in and stands there looking at me while I've no top on. She's only about seven.
Why haven't you got a top on?
Because he cuts my hair.
You don't have to take your top off to have your hair cut.
I don't want hair on my shirt.
If you went to a normal hairdresser, you wouldn't take your top off.
I'm not a normal hairdresser. I'm at Iqbal's house in his kitchen.
Yes, I know, but don't take it... That's even worse in front of his daughter.
His daughter shouldn't be there. She should be outside playing.
It's her house.
This is
a perking me up. It's like a little barocca in the radio.
I woke up today with this feeling. Better things are coming my way. And if this sun is shining to meaning, a better thing to be than better than me. When the rainy days are dying, when the people keep on crying, all the bees and birds are flying.
The bees and birds are dying. I like the singing that. Keep moving, don't stop rocking.
Get on up when you're down.
Alright, alright, I'm off, I'm driving.
I can't do it.
I know it's not much, but it's okay. I
keep on moving on anyway.
If you've seen this in the news today, apparently there are thought to be 4 million naturists in the UK now. Yes, those people who like to be at one with nature at special camps across the UK.
And it wouldn't be into that, you.
Does what?
Be into that.
To these camps now. You know, that got me thinking.
4 million what?
Nudists.
Doing what?
Then it struck me. Hang on a second.
Being nude.
Seriously, one of your colleagues probably loves to walk around naked at the weekends. Who is
it? I couldn't do that in front of other people.
My friend's mum and dad do it.
Where?
I don't know where. In a caravan or something, I don't know.
Would you not be cold?
That would be the least of your worries.
There's 4 million of them.
I don't even like looking at myself in the bath, let alone anyone else looking at me.
They must be freezing.
They must be filthy pigs. Gets me when you see them playing tennis and stuff.
Everything swinging about.
And they're never good looking. And
no.
Slim.
No.
They're always old, fat and ugly. Like... aren't they? I do like taking my bra off when I get home at night, though.
Got an apple fruit?
Yes, please. Thank you. Have you got any other colours?
Red. You want red?
Thank you. Shouldn't really eat one. But hey, why not?
Can't get into this bastard.
My friend's flatmate's sister's flatmate's friend made cheese on toast with Paul Weller.
And that's a claim to fame.
Well, what's yours?
I want to try and get Roddle's autograph.
But you couldn't do it?
Anyway. I'm sure Rodhold would just give anyone's autograph.
Well, that's what you think, but he couldn't sign autographs, according to his manager, because his writing hands up the bird.
Well, no, but he can still...
That's a false arm, isn't it? That's his dummy arm, and his writing hands up Emu. So he couldn't sign anything. That's just stuck a pen in Emu's mouth, and that killed the magic, wasn't it? Did you hear about Rodhold's funeral?
Is this a joke?
No. What? Funeral was crap, but reception was good.
Good.
Did you get it?
I thought you said it wasn't a joke.
Well, if I say it's a joke, and you're expecting it, and it is a joke, but I lied. No, get it?
The funeral was shit, but the reception was good.
I don't get it.
He fell off his roof fixing his TV aerial.
Oh, is that because he had a false arm?
What?
This is Forever FM.
Hundreds of people are missing after an office building collapsed in Mexico City.
Bloody hell, fire, that's a bad dude.
But it's feared many people are still trapped under the rubble.
Oh, God, imagine that.
At least I get to leave work early.
Don't be awful, bloody hell.
So didn't you used to want that to happen when you were in school?
What? A landslide on school?
Your school to go on fire.
No.
I did.
No, I did not.
Didn't you? That your school would be flooded over the weekend.
No, I didn't mind if it snowed when we were off school, but I didn't want it bloody burned out.
Oh, I did.
Friggin' ask this, do you? Oh, thank the Lord. Stevie Winwood, come on. call on me, Valerie.
Are you making the Valerie bit up?
What?
Are you making the Valerie bit up?
I'm the same boy I used to be. Am I making the what bit up?
Valerie bit.
It's called Valerie.
I never knew that.
It's called Valerie, Stevie Winwood. Are you deaf? Valerie!
Shh, don't sing it!
No, no.
Valerie! Oh, I never knew that.
Really?
No, seriously.
Thick as pig shit.
Valerie! I just thought it was call on me.
Big finish now, Stevie. Ready?
I'm the same boy I used to be.
Deal with it.
Silly.
Regret, new order.
Have you got any regrets?
The only regret I have is I didn't go and watch Simon and Garfunkel at Manchester Arena when they did a show in 2004. I were on nights working. What's that face for?
That's not a regret.
Bloody is it?
That hasn't changed your life.
She said regret, she didn't say what kind. I mean, I'd been waiting for that since I was...
You could say I regret missing curry last night.
No, that's not the same.
Well, that's exactly the same.
Isn't it always the same?
It's entertainment.
You can have entertainment regrets.
Well, no, you can't.
Well, I can have whatever I like.
It's not going to change your life and make you depressed.
Well, that's made me depressed, actually, because I...
You need to get out more, John.
Don't say that. I've always had a love for Simon and Garfunkel. Just the two voices together intertwined. Always... What? Always has done. It's timeless. Well, you asked me about any regrets, and I tell you.
I was listening.
What were you yawning for?
Do you want to ask me?
Have you any regrets, Kaylee?
No, I haven't.
Oh, there you go.
Well, I have.
Oh, okay.
I regret not finishing my hair and beauty course.
No, that's shit. See, you want to sound and Garfunkel, and I would say, what's that all about?
Then, if I was a beautician now, it's just because I got a phobia about feet and smelly women.
Well, that's a bit of a setback in the old beautician game.
I couldn't do it.
Yeah.
If I was a beautician now, I wouldn't be working here, and I wouldn't be car sharing with you, and you wouldn't have met me.
Well,
that would have been one of your regrets.
Oh, so you've spun that round there, the old Jedi mind trick.
Wouldn't it?
Yeah. What?
Wouldn't it?
Yeah, all right. Well, in writing.
Would it?